Testing shoulder flexion against gravity position. Patient will be in a seated position. First thing you will have your patient do, perform full range of motion into flexion. So go ahead, Rachel, perform flexion for me. As high as you can go and back down. Because she's able to do that, we know that she is a 3. Now, Rachel, I want you to come about halfway. I will stabilize the scapula. Push down on the humerus. I will not cross the elbow joint as that will be crossing 2 joints. So resist me, Rachel. 3, 2, 1. Depending on her resistance, I will rate her as a 4 or a 5. Testing shoulder flexion, gravity eliminated position. Patient will be sidelined with the arm resting comfortably by the side. To help the patient in range of motion for this, I will be simply supporting the arm and not actually assisting her in the range of motion itself. So let me demonstrate. So Rachel, perform shoulder flexion for me and come back. Because if she had any range of motion while doing that, I would consider that a 2. If she does not have any range of motion, I would palpate the anterior deltoid right here. If I feel this muscle firing, that is a 1. And if I do not feel it firing, that is a 0. Shoulder extension against gravity position. The patient will be in a prone position, or you can have them in a seated position. But for right now, we're gonna have her in a prone position. So first thing you will have your patient do is have them perform shoulder extension as far back as they can go. So go ahead and do that for me, please. And then go back down. Because she was able to do that, that is a grade 3. Go perform extension again, except go about halfway. I will stabilize the scapula, push down on the humerus. I will not cross the elbow as that will be crossing 2 joints. Resist me, 3, 2, 1, leg down. Testing shoulder extension, gravity eliminated position. Patient will be in a sideline position as shown here. So as I perform this, I will be supporting her arm, but I will not be assisting her in the extension itself. So go ahead and perform shoulder extension for me, please. Come back. Now, because she was able to perform that would be a grade 2. If she could not, I would palpate for the posterior deltoid found here. If I feel the muscle firing, that is a grade 1. If I do not feel it firing, that is a grade 0. Testing internal rotation, also known as medial rotation, against gravity position. You'll have your patient in a prone position with her arm hanging off the table. You will have your patient perform full internal rotation to the best of their ability. So go ahead and do that for me, please. There we go, let it back down. Because she was able to do that is a grade 3. Go ahead and go up about halfway for me, please. Okay, I'm going to stabilize the scapula and push down on the forearm. Now, note again, I'm crossing the elbow. This is one of the few exceptions you will be doing this with. So go ahead and resist me. 3, 2, 1. There we go. Testing internal rotation, also known as medial rotation, gravity eliminated position. Patient will be in a prone position as shown here, shoulder once again hanging off the table. You'll first have your patient perform internal rotation to the best of their ability. So go ahead and do that. Yep, just like that. Okay, then you're done with that. Because she was able to do that is a grade 2. If she could not do that, then I would palpate right here for the subscapularis and the teres major. If I feel these muscles firing, that would be a grade 1. If I do not feel them firing, that is a grade 0. Testing shoulder external rotation, also known as lateral rotation. Patient will be in a prone position as shown here. First thing you'll have your patient do is perform external rotation to the best of their ability. So go ahead and do that for me, please. And now I'll come back down. Because she was able to do that is a 3. I will now stabilize the scapula. Go ahead and do that motion about halfway. And then I will apply resistance to the forearm. Now note, I am crossing the elbow joint. This is one of the few exceptions that you will do this. Now resist me. 3, 2, 1. Okay, let back down. Testing shoulder external rotation, gravity eliminated position. Patient will be in a prone position as shown here and have the arm hanging off the table. You will then have your patient perform external rotation to the best of their ability with their palm facing you. So go ahead and do that for me. Okay, thank you. Because she was able to do that, that is a grade 2. If she could not do that, then I would come up and I would palpate the infraspinatus and the teres minor that are located about right here. If I feel these muscles firing, that is a grade 1. If I do not feel them firing, that is a grade 0. Testing shoulder abduction against gravity position. Patient would be seated, shoulder comfortably by the side, palm facing forward. For first thing you will have your patient do is perform full shoulder abduction. Go ahead and do that for me, Rach. Come back down. Because she's able to do that, we know that it is at least a grade 3. To test for grades 4 and 5, I will test for two separate muscles, the supraspinatus and the middle deltoid. To do the supraspinatus, I will first have Rachel perform 20 degrees of abduction. So go ahead and go about 20 degrees. I will stabilize the scapula and push down on the humerus here. Resist me, Rachel. 3, 2, 1. To test for the middle deltoid, I will have her go into 90 degrees of abduction. Once again, stabilize the scapula, push down on the humerus.
Resist me. 3, 2, 1. Come back down.
Depending on her resistance, I will grade her as a 4 or a 5 for those individual muscles. Testing shoulder abduction, gravity eliminated position. Patient will be supine, arm comfortably at the side, palm facing upward. When she performs abduction, if you notice, she's sliding across the table here, but if you do not have a table, or if her shoulder is hanging off the table, you can support her with your own hands, but just make sure that you're supporting her and not assisting her into abduction. So when testing abduction, I will be once again testing for two muscles, the supraspinatus and the middle deltoid. I will have my patient perform 20 degrees of abduction first. So go ahead and do that for me, Rachel. Because she's able to, and now bring it back in. Because she's able to do that, I will grade her as a 2 for the supraspinatus. Now, Rachel, I want you to go out 90 degrees of abduction. Good, bring it back. Because she's able to do that, I would grade her as a 2 for the middle deltoid. If she could not have any range of motion, then I would palpate the middle deltoid located here. If I feel this muscle firing, that is a grade 1. If I do not feel it firing, that is a grade 0. Testing horizontal abduction against gravity position. Patient will be in a prone position, arm hanging off the table as shown here. Patient will first perform full horizontal abduction to the best of their ability. So go ahead and perform that for me, please. Then back down. Now you will have because she was able to do that, we know she's a grade 3. Now you will have them come about halfway. So come up about halfway. I will stabilize her scapula and push down on her humerus. Resist me. 3, 2, 1, and let back down. Testing horizontal abduction, gravity eliminated position. Patient can be in a seated position with her arm put up on this table as shown here with her forearm extended outward. Now in a clinical setting, you most likely will not have this platform. You'll probably need to help the patient in this full range of motion with your hands. But for right now, we're gonna do it on the table. So first thing, I would like my patient to perform full horizontal abduction in this position. So go ahead and do that for me. Bring it all the way back. There we go. Because she was able to perform that in this position, that is a grade 2. If she could not, I would palpate for the posterior deltoid found here. If I feel this muscle firing, that is a grade 1. And if I do not feel it firing, that is a grade 0. Testing horizontal adduction against gravity. Patient will be in a supine position, shoulder hanging off the table, forearm extended upward. First thing you'll have your patient do is perform full horizontal adduction to the best of their ability. So go ahead and do that for me, please. And go back. Because she was able to go all the way over her chest and back, we'd grade that as a level 3. Now I want you to come about halfway, right there. I will stabilize the scapula and I will push down on the humerus. 3, 2, 1, 0. Testing horizontal adduction, gravity eliminated position. Patient will be in a seated position with her arm supported on the table as shown here. You will have your patient then cross her arm and hand across midline as best as she can. So go ahead and do that and now bring it back. Because she was able to do this with a gravity eliminated position, that is a grade 2. If she could not do this, I would palpate the pectoralis major found here. If I feel firing, that would be a grade 1, and if I do not feel this muscle firing, that'd be a grade 0.